Well, welcome to our next lecture, which is regarding your next milestone, where we're going to talk about the SWOT analysis and core competencies, which is core competencies come from the strengths, okay? Not the threats, not the opportunities, and not the weaknesses. Core competency comes from the strengths. So when you're writing your paper and you're talking about your strengths, some of those could be, in fact, core competencies, and you could bring them down and answer that question. So let's talk about the different aspects of this. Let's see if we can do that. Okay, so I'm going to ask you again to use the template that I've provided, and in this lecture, I'm going to give you examples of what another student had done for Milestone 2. Let's start off by looking at the title page. Notice it says running head, it's got the student's name, it's got the date, and it has my name. Okay? So you can always come back to this video and pause it and look at the title page. Okay, so then we have a table of contents. You need to put the page numbers in, okay? That's the way I know that you've gotten at least 8 pages and that you've answered all of the questions that I'm asking, okay? So please put the page numbers in. And then let me give you some backup. These are the page numbers, the names on the table of contents will also be your questions. So provide your research under the topics listed. Remember, this is an 8 to 10 page paper, and so we're looking for depth in your discoveries. Erase this box before you submit your paper. So here is what you're going to do. You've got an introduction, and then you answer that. Identify and analyze 4 strengths, okay? Strengths come from within the company. Weaknesses are weaknesses within the company. Opportunities happen outside the company, and threats happen outside the company. So you'll answer these questions, and those questions are basically the topics in the table of contents. So where does this go? Let's just look at this a little bit. The introduction, identifying a company's strength, weaknesses, and opportunities and threats can aid in creating a strategy plan. I'm not going to read the whole thing, but if you want to go back and take a look at it and see how this was answered, go back to the video, stop it. Then you're going to identify and analyze 4 strengths. So here, Apple has 1 strength that competitors have yet to catch up with, and that is their, I can barely read it, their broad recognition. Okay, so go through that. That'll give you an idea of how to answer these topics. It's not that difficult if you use this. Okay, ethical issues. I'm skipping around. So as a stated threat, the working conditions of factories in China, and the problem is when we're talking about ethical issues, we're talking about ethical issues in the product. For instance, in India, they use child labor. They pay them 16 cents a day. In China, they pay them basically nothing. The working conditions are terrible. So you want to look into that, okay? A couple of paragraphs, you know, you'll be fine. Okay, so I'm not going to go very much further with that. So you now are on what we call core competencies, and that is your second milestone paper. We're going to go through some of that now, so let's just see what happens. Okay, remember I said a specially prepared template for this assignment has been created to make the assignment easier. Please use it. references should not be older than 2014. In-text citations must be written in proper APA, substantiate the facts, and provide evidence to support or prove the truth of the information presented. Observation and opinion should be supported with a reference. Paraphrase to avoid plagiarism. Incomplete papers will be returned with no grade for completion. And then ask questions. Now, let's talk about incomplete papers. You can, if you turn in an incomplete paper on the Sunday that the paper's due, and you tell me that it's incomplete, I'll give you an extra couple of days, all right? You cannot pass this class if you haven't done these milestones. Your final paper is worth 350 points. So this class is not just predicated on points. You have to do a complete final paper in order to pass the class, okay? It's not just on points, so I hope you know that. Week 5 guidelines. For the company you've chosen, write a paper that identifies and analyzes at least 4, but no more than 8, strengths and weaknesses. Then assess opportunities, threats, and ethical issues that may affect new business activities or offerings. You may use topics listed in the Module 4 discussion or others that you deem important. Continue your paper by identifying and explaining 3 to 5 core competencies. Remember, core competencies come from your strengths. So if you have 8 strengths, you have 3 to 5 already to pick from. All you're going to do then is just, you know, expand on them for the company you've chosen and or product. Explain how, by the way, a SWOT analysis is the company, not the product. Explain how and why they are not easily duplicatable by the competition, okay? And explain how these core competencies dovetail with your new product or service offering. Upon which competency or competencies will the new business offering benefit and why? And what strategic implications will or could this have on the new offering? Okay, so you're going to have an introduction, you're going to identify 4 strengths, identify and analyze 4 weaknesses, opportunities, threats, ethical issues that may affect new business activities or offerings. You're going to identify and explain 3 to 5 core competencies for the company you've chosen. Core competencies come from where? From the company strengths. Explain how and why they're not easily duplicatable by the competition. Although they could. I mean, let's say your company makes toasters with a smart, application involved. People could still buy other toasters. They don't have to buy yours. But, you know, if they want a toaster with smart accessible, then they can't duplicate it, or they could, but it would take a while. Explain how these core competencies dovetail with your new product or service offering. Explain which competency or competencies will the new business offering benefit and why, and what strategic implications will or could this have on the new offering. Okay, remember, a lot of these things, these words, can be found, or definitions can be found in your textbook. Introduction, identify and analyze 4 strengths, identify and analyze 4 weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. So the term SWOT stands for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. A SWOT analysis is a management tool that concentrates on providing an evaluation of these factors as they apply to a particular business as well as the environment and market it operates in. A SWOT is divided into 2 parts, internal, which is within the company, and external factors. The internal component of a SWOT focuses on the strengths and weaknesses, and the external component focuses on particular business as well as the environment and market it operates. A SWOT is divided into two parts, like I said, internal factors. The internal component of a SWOT focuses on the strengths and weaknesses, and the external component focuses on the opportunities and threats that may impact a business, performance, or strategy. To view an overall overview of a SWOT, click. Okay. Internal factors are within the control and take place within the business environment. Some examples are operational issues, efficiency, staff and employees, capacity, resources available to match supply and demand, cash flow, revenues, costs, payroll, equipment, rent, productivity, and meeting the deadlines. External factors are general conditions and environmental outside the control of the organization. Some examples are the general business environment, interest rates and demographics, economic change, deterioration in the geographic regional market, product availability, materials are no longer available, industry market customer trends, changes in the competitive landscape, technology trends, and regulation laws. And that could be government regulation laws, and that could thwart, you know, a problem. That could be a threat. Examples of strengths to look for. Okay, this is really important. The size of the company relative to others in the industry, balance sheet strength, cash flows, perception of the company's products, perception of the company's brands, what advantages the company has over its competitors. In general, what does the company do well? Examples of opportunities to look for. New markets for products, financial or legal trouble for competitors, new technologies the company could adopt, changes in regulatory tax burdens, strategic investments, internal efficiencies. Examples of threats to look for. Internal obstacles the company is facing, financial constraints on the company, cash flow problems, the relative position of the company's largest competitors, technological advances in the industry if the company isn't keeping pace, and new technologies that threaten to displace the company's products. Examples of weaknesses to look for. Deteriorating balance sheet, poor perception of company's brands and or products, advantages over other companies have, lack of management or other employee talent. In general, what does the company do poorly? So ethical issues that may affect new business activities or offerings. Fundamental activities, ethical issues. The most fundamental or essential ethical issues that businesses must face are integrity and trust. A basic understanding of integrity includes the idea of conducting your business affairs with honesty and a commitment to treating every customer fairly. When customers think a company is exhibiting an unwavering commitment to ethical business practices, a high level of trust can develop between the business and the people it seeks to serve. A relationship of trust between you and your customers may be a key factor in your company's success. Ethical issues that may affect new business activities or offerings, diversity and the respectful workplace. Your current and potential employees are a diverse pool of people who deserve to have their differences respected when they choose to work at your business. An ethical response to diversity begins with recruiting a diverse workforce, enforces equal opportunity in all training programs, and is fulfilled when every employee is able to enjoy a respectful workplace environment that values their contributions. Maximizing the value of each employee's contribution is a key element in your business. Decision-making issues. A useful method for exploring ethical dilemmas and identifying ethical courses of action includes collecting the facts, okay? Evaluating any alternative actions, making a decision, testing the decision for fairness, and reflecting on the outcome. Ethical decision-making process should center on protecting employee and customer rights, making sure all business operations are fair and just, protecting the common good, and making sure the individual values and beliefs of workers are protected. Compliance and governance issues. Businesses are expected to fully comply with environmental laws, federal and state safety regulations, fiscal and monetary reporting statutes, and all applicable civil rights laws. Now, this happened sometimes when these big companies dump chemicals into these rivers and the fish die and people are dying. I mean, these are unethical practices. And sometimes the government gets involved. For example, the Aluminum Company of America, Alcoa, approach to compliance ensures no one at the company may ask any employee to break the law or go against company values, policies, and procedures. The company's commitment to compliance is shored up by its approach to corporate governance. The company expects all Alcoa directors, officers, executives to conduct business in accordance with its business conduct policies. Okay? Does your company have a business conduct policies? Think about it. So you're going to identify and explain 3 to 5 core competencies for the company you've chosen. Innovation of cutting-edge products. Innovative companies have a competitive edge in the marketplace. Quality and reliability, okay? Quality means reliability and performance. Japanese automakers gradually took over market leadership by making quality one of their core competencies. Exceptional customer service. Small businesses that provide exceptional customer services have a competitive edge in the market. Stay flexible to stay competitive. Companies must be nimble to stay competitive. For a small business, this could mean exploring market niches that bigger competitors are not pursuing or teaming up with businesses to gain market share. Other core competencies. Other core competencies that give organizations competitive advantage include strategic customer targeting and a superior internet presence. So you're going to be asked to explain why they are not easily duplicated, you know, by your competition. Core competencies allow small businesses to develop value to their customers. But what are core competencies? The litmus test is it hard for competitors to copy or develop? Okay, so we're talking about explaining how these core competencies dovetail with your new product or service offering. So what does dovetail mean? It's a verb, to fit together or to cause to fit together nicely, synergistically. And some uses. Our schedules dovetailed nicely at the conference. Okay, so they fit together. My experience as a CPA dovetailed nicely with my job as a financial analyst. Okay, so that'll give you an idea what we mean by dovetail. So explain which competencies will the new business offering benefit and why. Okay, a more current definition of core competency would be key abilities or strengths that a company has developed that give it a competitive advantage over its peers and contribute to its long-term success. Core competencies are difficult for competing businesses to duplicate. Now, can you think of something that another company can't duplicate? Well, let's take Apple computers. You know, for a long time, there were two platforms. There was the PC and the Mac, okay? Very, very few people were able to duplicate the Mac. They had they had different electronics inside that were proprietary, and nobody went that direction. A lot of people went with the PC because it was much easier. The components were easy to come by. And also, the Mac was a graphical, you know, GUI, graphical user interface. So it was colorful, it had windows, it was, I mean, it was very, very cool. Corporations exist to earn profits, okay? Remember this, there's no reason to be in business if you don't make money. And provide, that includes even nonprofits. They have to pay their staff. So corporations exist to earn profits and provide wealth to their shareholders, okay? The board of directors in small corporations, typically, these individuals are the shareholders, and management set the goals and objectives for the company. How the company pursues its goals is its corporate strategy. Get it? Corporate strategy has implications for several areas of the company. Corporations exist to earn profits and provide wealth to their shareholders. Okay? How the company pursues its goals is a corporate strategy. Okay. So, corporate strategy defined. Corporate strategy is the overall direction a corporation takes to achieve business success. Marketing implications. A company with customer-focused strategic objectives will have a corporate strategy that impacts its marketing. Knowledge-based synergies. Another strategic implication is the impact of knowledge on the company as a whole. A corporate strategy may involve introducing new products or opening up a new location each year. Now, let's talk about new products first. We have a brand. We've talked about that. The brand is the company that makes the product, and the product is what they sell. So when we talk about adding new things, we call that brand extension. So maybe we have, Nike has gym clothes. And now they may decide to go with regular jeans and shirts and jackets and things like that. And they extend their brand to increase their revenue flow. Technological implications. A corporation strategy has technological implications. For example, a company may shift from advertising in newspapers to advertising in online blogs or newsletters. Well, that is actually what has transpired. And now it's even more so because we have what's called influencer marketing, and we have Instagram, and we have people that are brand ambassadors that have followings. Influencer marketing are these people that put out all kinds of different communications and messages, and maybe they have a million followers. And so advertisers are now buying space on their blog, and it's very successful. Personal needs. Corporate strategy has implications for personnel. The strategy dictates how fast the company expands, what products and services it provides, and how the company grows. For example, through increased sales and marketing or through acquisition. Additional guidelines. Use the template provided. Do not change the table of contents. Answer every one of these questions completely. Add page numbers. Make sure you have in-text citations. Every reference you have needs to have an in-text citations. I don't care if you use it 5 times. Make sure you have in-text citations, and every reference has an in-text citation. References before 2014 will not be accepted unless you contact me and explain why. Because we want to keep this very current. Claim evidence analysis resources. Effective paragraphs are important in all types of writing. Your paragraphs guide your reader through the paper by helping to explain, substantiate, and support your thesis statement or argument. Each paragraph should discuss one major point or idea. An effective paragraph has 3 parts: claim, evidence, and analysis. Claim. This is also sometimes called a topic sentence. This will be your way of announcing the main focus of your photo, your paragraph. Sorry. It should tell the reader what your paragraph will be about. It may be helpful to think of your claims as mini arguments that support the paper's main argument or thesis. Just as in the thesis statement, your topic sentences should be debatable. In other words, they should be arguable claims that you will try to prove with your evidence. Evidence. This is how you support or back up your claims. The evidence will help to prove each claim to the reader. Analysis, concluding observation. Your analysis or concluding observation is the way of wrapping up the information presented in your paragraph. It should explain why the evidence supports your claim and why this supports the main thesis in your paper. One of the things that I would like you to start thinking about is if you use the word "in my opinion" or, you know, "my observation," make sure, though, you base it on something. So, in my opinion, based on an article I read by, you know, Henry Ford, dot, 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 dot. That's acceptable. But explain where you got the information to make the assumption or the observation. Observation and opinion should be supported with a reference. Well, I went through that as fast as I could. So I have provided lots of information in the announcements, the template. This video will have examples, and I hope you do well on your paper. Remember, this is part two. Part three is basically done with the assignment, because all you'll need to do for the final paper is what we call an executive summary. Won't take you very long. And at that point, this class will be over, and I hope you like all of the information I'm providing, my templates and such. If you have any issues, contact me. I am very, very open, and I would love to hear from you if you have any advice for the class, how I'm teaching the class, and or you have any questions about your assignments. Hey, take care. Have a wonderful week. And we will see you in the class. This is Professor Phil Schaps telling you to go out and write. Goodbye.